Yeah, hello, I would like to welcome you to our webinar Forex Trading. Today we want to present you some basic information, how to get started for Forex trading in the TradeStation Global platform as well as in the Trader Workstation. So, like always, for the beginning, just the legal disclaimer that there's no investment advice or trading recommendations included in this video. And yeah, if you would like to see more videos, you can follow us on our YouTube channel here or check our website for the next upcoming webinars. And feel free to contact us if there's anything what you need to know as well. So let's go straight to the TradeStation platform. There are many different tools for Forex trading. Today we want to focus on three tools. What is radar screen, matrix, and chart analysis. And especially chart analysis is one big benefit of the TradeStation Global platform. If you compare it to the Trader Workstation, you have many different indicators. Chart trading is also available. And the chart itself, it's I think much better to use than what you can use in the Trader Workstation platform. So we would like to start with the chart trading. So first of all, if you have the TSIB default workspace open, just click in the chart and activate chart trading. And then you will see on your right the following information. First of all, your account, what you see here in the beginning. We are here on a paper trading account, what you can see when it starts with a D at the beginning. And below this, you can see the quantity. The default setting is always one lot, what means 100,000. And after this, you see the duration. Forex is also one asset class what makes it possible to do day trading for short or for like smaller accounts. And just make sure if you place an order, which should be valid over the actual trading day, you should change the duration in GTC, because they, if the order will be not executed, it will be deleted after the end of the day. So if you want to make sure that it's valid more than one day, then use GTC, what gives you the possibility to place an order maximum for 90 days or till you cancel it or till it's get filled. So GTC, good till cancel, you should use for orders which should be available more than one day in the market. Then we have very simple 8 buttons for buying and selling positions, which you see here, place order. And this is where we want to start. The first two buttons, which you see on top, buy, and then you see below a price. This means always placing a limit order on the best bid price, and for sell on the best ask price. So we would just place a limit order, a bit smaller, and the same for the other size. If you want to sell the position, it's also a limit order, which you can place here. You will always see the price below. And if you place the order, it should be also displayed here in the chart itself. Just click on it and you can later change it. If you don't want to wait till a limit order gets filled, this fastest way is always buy a market where you accept every price. Just be aware there can be a small slippage, or depending on the spread, your execution can be a little bit away from the latest price. And the other two orders which are here below, take and hit, means also limit order, but other than the buttons on top, take means limit order to the best ask, and hit a limit order to the best bid. And the color gives you also the information. All what you find on your left is for buying, and all on your right with the red color is for selling. So what we can do, we can place a buy market order, and then you can try to set a trailing stop order. What's also very smart, you can do it in points and in percentage. I would always recommend to do it in percentage, so you can define your risk, for example, with 0.5%, and then later on change it here in the order, in the chart window itself, where you will display where it will display all the orders you set. The next step, we will do this now for trailing stop order. Just let me change the screen. If I want to invest in a longer period of time, I will just change the trailing stop on a different time frame. Sometimes if the chart is not loading fast enough in the TradeStation application, just try to reduce the days back, so everything will come a little bit faster. So I see, okay, my trailing stop is below this, the last lows, and the trailing stop, this is the important thing, it will move as long as the currency pair is going up. So my trailing stop will always run behind my position, or like behind the last price, with a distance of 0.5%. Only if it's going down, I know I can't risk more than what is set now for this trailing stop order. So it's a pretty good way to secure your position and to make sure that if it's going in the right direction, that you also will reduce your risk. And if it's going up, let's say more than 0.5%, my trailing stop order will be at my entry price level. So then I can't make any loss, as long as there's no gap. Let's say overnight gaps are only existing for Forex at a weekend, but yeah, this is something what can also happen if you are invested in a position over the weekend. So this is the basic facts for chart trading. You can also cancel all orders here, or what is also a smart way to let's cancel this trailing stop order, because there's another order I want to show you. This is exit breakout, 1L, 1S means one limit, one stop order. And here you see, I can also change this stop order in a chart, and for example, as well as my target order. I always recommend to find a good ratio between risk and reward. You should always risk less than what your performance will be. So, and I think it's also a pretty easy way to set this up in a chart. So this is place the OCO. So trailing stop or OCO should be good for exit. Then cancel all, cancel active orders. I think this is clear so far. Reverse, if you're like really a short-term intraday trader and you see the position is going against you, you can even reverse your position. We can try this because we are in a paper trading account now. Means I'm invested with one mini lot long. And if I press reverse, you see, it will make three actions at the end. And these three actions are canceling all existing orders. This is the first thing what will happen. The second thing, it will close my existing position. And the third thing is to open a position in the other direction, means like now we are short invested, and this is all with this button reverse, what makes it pretty simple if you really want to change your position a bit faster than do it manually. And all the information for your position, it's displayed after this. So I see I have an open profit loss of $1, 0.01% in minus. And if I change this to any of the other currencies, currency pairs where we already invested, we should see exactly the same. And especially for positions like here, Euro USD, where we are a little bit more in profit, it's interesting. We have 2.8% profit, and the absolute value is 970 euros. So this is chart trading. I mean, the rest for chart, it's also pretty simple. You can include even strategies or indicators. If you want to see some more technical analysis, you find a lot of indicators here. Everything as standard indicators should be already included. If there's anything what you need to see or what you are missing, we can do this, or we can also implement individual indicators. So let us know. I think you have our contact details. Otherwise, we will also display this at the end of the webinar. So feel free to contact us if there's anything what you might miss or where you need our help to set it up. Yeah, this is chart trading and matrix. It's another way to handle your position, to have a good overview about all the information. Let's make it a little bit bigger. If it's the format window. Yeah, if the letters are on your screen not big enough, you can also change this in matrix. So format window will give you the opportunity to change each and everything, not only the size, also some colors. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Okay, there's no volume bars displayed for Forex. You will see this only for other asset classes. But what is also important, I think this is the general setup, like you should find it also from the beginning. The open P&L here, the first column which we see is always should be set up in the base currency, but you can also change the columns, what's pretty easy, and some useful columns you can also add is simple currency, account currency, and percentage. For me, also very important to see a percentage of profit, what we earlier saw also in the chart trading. So we are already 3.3% in profit, and the rest works pretty much the same what we had in chart trading. You have buttons on the right-hand side for placing a market order, for trading stop as well. You have the same what we did for OCO orders. You can cancel, reverse, or close positions. So there's almost the same buttons and settings what we found in a chart trading. So I don't think this is a needs another explanation. But what is quite smart in the matrix is if you put your order type to auto limit stop, means you don't have to decide is it a limit order, is it a stop order, because if I want to place maybe another entry order for Euro USD to a cheaper price than what it is at the moment, you will see it will show me automatically a limit order. But when I want to trade a breakout, for example, when I let's say I think it will break out above this level of $1 and 184 cent, then I can just place it here, and the system will automatically decide if it's a stop or limit order. So there's nothing for you to change. And it's the opposite if I want to sell, because I want to sell to a better price. It's always a limit order. But when I want to say if it's falling down below 3% of profit, I can also place a stop order here. So this is all pretty easy and simple. Just make sure that you don't put like more than one exit order, because this means at the end, if you have more than one exit order or you forgot to delete one maybe, then the second exit order can be a new entry order, and the system will allow to set up as many exit orders as you want. So it's always on you to check if there's only one or if you set up more than one exit order. And it's the same way if you have it in the matrix. We can also change it later in the chart, because everything is connected to each other. It's the same if we go to the trader workstation. What we will do in the next minutes, you will find of course all the orders which we set up here there as well, and you can change it in the trader workstation in the same way what we did here in the TradeStation platform. Yeah, changing columns was the last thing, and order set up, like I said, if order is placed, we can also drag and drop orders in the same way like in the chart. So this functionality works in all ways the same. Just if you want to place some more I don't want to say complicated, but more complex orders or order combination, you should have a look to the menu view, and then there will be order bar. What we see on top should be also coming up after opening the TradeStation platform in the beginning. So this is something what you should see from the beginning. And the order entry bar gives you some more possibilities for placing OCO or order sense orders. You can even customize your orders. So let's say, for example, we can make a practical example. British pound USD, we also invested already, then maybe we will stay on British pound Japanese yen. And let's decide what we want to do. Let's say we want to do a breakout order when it goes above 140 Japanese yen. We want to invest in the market. So we can go to a custom order sense order. Here it's a bit different. We have to place, include the symbol first, and then buy 10,000. So you set up everything what is needed. Stop, let's say stop market. We say stop was 140. You can also change this later in the chart or in the matrix as well. And then we can attach OCO order. So what we did manually in a chart at the beginning, we can set this up all together. We can set up an entry order, and as soon as the entry order gets filled, we will include OCO order as well with a limit. Let's say breakout limit should be 140 and our stop 138. So these combinations of orders should be always placed in this order bar, because in a chart or in a matrix, you will not find this a little bit more complex orders. So just make sure if you want to place entry order with exit order that you use the OCO or order sense order button here, and with the customize function, that should be everything possible. And then we can see our Entry Order here, Stop. Das ist our Stop Buy Order, Stop Sell Order and our Sell Limit Order as a Profit Target. And then after it's set up, we can also change it here the same way what we did earlier. So this is, I think, pretty easy, pretty simple. And with the chart functionality of the TradeStation Global platform, I think it will help you a lot to improve your trading style, to get all the information you need to know with all the indicators which are also available. There should be a big benefit for your trading style. But just to make sure that you know everything about how to use the TradeStation platform and the benefits of it, I just want to show you something for radar screen, because the same what we did in the chart, we can also set it up in a radar screen. We can include indicators. So if there's something what you are missing, let's say you want to have the RSI, or we also have like some sort of alert functions what we programmed here. You just can implement this as an indicator in the radar screen, and then you can even sort the forex pairs with the highest or lowest RSI. I can also set an alert for like many same currencies. For example, we had euro, sorry, it was British pound, USD, Japanese yen. So I have a very simple alert function where I say, okay, if this goes above 140, where I want to invest, I want to have an alert. And if it's going down 138, I want to see the same. And you can set this up for many different symbols. You see the price where the alert will be set up, and then the alert itself. I think you will find also very useful videos in our YouTube channel, how to set up an alert. It's should be available in almost every indicator. It doesn't matter if you include it in the chart analysis or on the radar screen. So you have the possibility to use this in all different tools. So normally there are three ways. Like you can have like a tone. If the price goes above 140, you can have a pop-up window and an email as well. And this should be selected by the alert what your preferences are matching. For me, it's always like in a tone if I'm not in front of the computer, because then I know, okay, now it's going above the price where I want to invest, and I just place my buy order manually. Or if I'm in front of the computer but doing some other stuff, writing some emails, then the pop-up window will also help you, because the pop-up window will always come in front of the screen. Even TradeStation is just running in the background. So these are really smart and easy ways to use some indicators to make your trading more efficient. So I guess these three tools for trading Forex, even other asset classes, will help you a lot. What I normally recommend, especially if you are just trading a few currency pairs, I have normally a second chart analysis window open. So what you can do, you can just go to the trading apps and open another chart window on a different interval. So for British pound, I want to see also the daily chart. Of course, you can also include chart trading here as well. So this will should work all fine. Just make sure that you link it in the same simple link what all the other windows are linked. And we have here green local symbol link. What does it mean? Local symbol link is always only in one workspace or on one desktop. If you want to have it linked over, let's say you use two or three screens and you want to have it linked with some other workspaces or desktops, you should always use the global linkage, because like I said, the local will only work in one workspace. So I will save this workspace, and if you want to have it, I'm happy to share it. Just feel free to send me a message, and we will make sure that you receive this workspace and you can use it in the same way what we have here. Even this indicator is specially programmed by us for the alert function, the radar screen, and there are many other indicators what we would also provide you for free as a TradeStation customer. And like I already told you in the beginning, if there's anything else what you miss or like some easy programs, we should be able to do this for you as well. Yeah, this is so far everything from the TradeStation
So you
side.
have
Some more time, I will include all the other currency pairs, or the main currency pairs here as well, so that you have at least 20 or 22 currency pairs included. If I send you the workspace, it will help you to have this available. You should save, I mean, you can save the workspace in every folder what you want to where you want to save it, but normally all the workspaces from TradeStation are saved under the following path. It's C program TradeStation 9.5, and then there's one folder my work, and here you can save the workspace if you get it from an external from an email, or if you even set up your own workspace, they should be all here in this folder. Yeah, so far this are the basics for Forex trading the TradeStation platform, and now I want to present you some more information here on the Trader Workstation. You see even the charting, it's not so nice, but I know a few people might not work with the TradeStation platform, so we decided to also give you some details about the Trader Workstation. If you go to open li layout library, you will have this selection of different libraries, so layouts here, and there's one for Forex, what you also can on your own needs. You have here like three different charts, starting with 2 minute candles. We have just a line chart for the for today, and then daily candles, similar to what we set up in the TradeStation platform. Economic news, related of course to currencies, also something what you can of course remove, and you can even wait if we go to US dollar, Japanese yen. Or you can search for different currencies, and if there's any information on it, like for the Japanese yen, and then basically for news or other researches, this economic events, so we as well as the news here below, will help you to dig deeper, if you are really into news. There's I think this is better to do it with the Trader Workstation. If it comes more to charting and placing orders in chart analysis, I would always recommend the TradeStation platform. I mean, you can easily see it. We have here only 10, 20 indicators what we can include in the chart of the Trader Workstation. So this makes much more sense to use the TradeStation platform. Just to show you what is available here. It's not the same, but you can also right-click in the chart, and then you will find Add Studies. There's a few studies already as a pre-selection. Okay, I'm wrong. It's maybe more than 25, but in TradeStation you will have much more than these indicators here. We will ha also have strategies, and you can, that's the most important thing, also set up your own indicators, what is not well possible with the Trader Workstation. Yeah, and what we did in the radar screen, what I think it's a better solution, you can also do this here in the quote, not quote panel, in this order panel. where we already have like 9 different currency pairs, EURUSD, USD Japanese Yen. And if there's something what you don't want to see here, because at the end you also see currency futures, the last three, you can just go here and change to some currency pair what we might missed here. For example, Euro, Japanese Yen. Yeah, then there's always coming the selection, IDL Pro or Smart CFD. So for Forex or currency trading, there's not only the currency pair at itself available. You can also use CFDs, of course, and futures, as it's included here, are also available for trading. But it doesn't matter what you choose. Nothing is related to pattern day trading rule, so you can do as many trades as possible. I think from the cost side, CFDs is also always something what I would not recommend. Even some people use it because the margin impact is a little bit less. But futures, currency futures, or the Forex pair itself, it's my personal preference to invest in currencies. So we will select IDL Pro. And then we will place, wait, we have a position for Euro USD already. Yeah. USD Swiss franc is literally here the same. And let's place an order here for 2 mini lots, because I just want to show you the margin impact, because this is not purely, or it's not like written like it should be in the trade station. So you see, for 2 mini lots, it's a really small change in the margin. You only need 128 when it's written correct here. So to check the margin impact, yeah, you should use this or select the trader workstation, and then it will exactly show you how what's your current margin, what will be the change, and how much margin you will use after this trade. So yeah, this is something what you might not find in TradeStation, but I think normally if you know about leverage and for Forex, it should be all pretty easy and simple for you to find out the correct margin what you need to place an order, and otherwise you can always check your account balance as well. So this was a basic introduction to Forex trading, to TradeStation and Trader Workstation. As I said in the beginning, feel free to contact us if there's anything what you might miss, or any indicators or the workspace I presented, what we should send you via email. And if you don't want to miss any of the upcoming videos, please subscribe here to our YouTube channel. And check our playlists, because there are many more good information how to use the TradeStation and Trader Workstation platform. So thank you very much for your attention, and have a great day. Bye bye.